So welcome back for our discussion about the million dollar question, million dollar topic, that is, does God exist? Some information about the human brain. The human brain can store more information than all the libraries in the world. This is not my statement. This is Dr. Richard. He's saying, he's the author about the brain book. Another information. The human brain is made of a trillion brain cells, and each one of these is more powerful and sophisticated than most computers around the planet today. Not the statement from me, it is Dr. Tony Buzan, is a British psychologist, educator and author. Some more information. Who made the natural intelligence of this incredibly complex computer, the human brain? So a normal computer, a supercomputer, needs a creator. And who made this most sophisticated computer, which is brain? Who made this? Likewise, we see so many wonderful things created by man. Sleek, trendy cars, someone manufactured it. Trendy computers, someone assembled it. Elegant watches, someone designed it. Architectural marvels, someone erected it. Skyscraper buildings, someone built it. Wonderful sculptures, someone carved it. Now, the second proof I present before all of you, that is, every creation implies a creator. Now, the question is, I'll give you time, you please think about it and try to find out, is there anything in this world which has come by chance without any creator? Now, shouldn't this universe have a super intelligent creator? Definitely yes. Now see, Isaac Newton, he says, I'll tell you a story and then I'll tell you some information what Newton gives. Newton, I don't know how many of you are aware, he was a great believer of God. So Isaac Newton had a close friend who was also a scientist, but he was an atheist. He never believed in God. One day, Newton thought, let me teach this atheist friend a big lesson of his life. So Newton invited his friend, please come tomorrow morning for breakfast to my house. And friend, Isaac Newton is inviting me. So he was excited to go for the breakfast. And Isaac Newton, he had made a step-down model of solar system, a dummy model of solar system, where the sun is there, earth and all the planets, which had a perfect rotation, revolution, everything was so perfect. And he had made that step-down model of solar system and had kept in the hall. And the friend was about to come in the morning at 9 o'clock, and 8:55, Newton went inside the room and locked himself, because he wanted his friend to come and see the model, and he wanted to teach him a lesson by that. So the friend comes, he knocks the door, and the door is open, and he enters, because Newton was his close friend. He enters and he is struck with wonder, and he sees what a beautiful model of solar system, and he sits and tries to analyze everything. Every parameter was so perfect and so precisely done. And he appreciates Newton. He says, hats off to Isaac Newton. You are so intelligent. You are so brilliant. You have made such a wonderful model. But Newton is not there. He is inside the room. And he says, Newton, where are you? I am already there inside your house. And Newton comes as if he is about to get up from the bed. And he says, oh, sorry, I slept late. I just forgot to invite you. So Newton just gets up from the bed. He acts as if he's getting up from the bed, and he comes, oh, sorry, I did not receive you properly. And friend says, that's okay. And friend says, Newton, you're amazing. What a beautiful model you have made. Hats off to your intelligence. Newton says, model? Which model? I have not made anything. And he says, see, this step-down model of solar system, what you have made, it is amazing. Hats off to you. And Newton says, come on. I have not made anything. I just came late from the party last night and slept. Just now I am getting up. And how did this model come? It is so beautiful. And Newton starts speaking about the model. Such a big prank. And friend says, Newton, don't act smartly. I know very well that you have made this. And I'm appreciating. And you are saying it has just come like that. And Newton argues, yes, last night this was not there. Today it has come. I think it has come by chance. And the friend says, no, it is not possible. Nothing can come by chance. Newton argues, no, it has come by chance. Friend says, no, it has not come by chance. And after that, Newton tells his friend, my dear friend, this simple step-down model cannot come by chance. Then, how come the entire universe, which is so perfect and which is working so precisely, can come by chance? What are the possibilities? You are not ready to believe that this simple model cannot come by chance, and you believe that the entire creation has come by chance, and there is no God, there is no creator. And friend was taken aback. And from that day onwards, Newton's friend started thinking, and he slowly became a believer of God. So Isaac Newton was a great believer, and he made sure that his friend also started believing in God or Creator. So, what do the best of the scientists feel about the creation? Quite interesting. Albert Einstein says, there is a perfect brain behind all the natural physical laws. Lord Kelvin says, if you think strongly enough, you will be forced by science to believe in God. Please be aware, these are all not my statements. These are all the statements by the greatest scientists. So Newton says, this most beautiful system of the sun, planets and comets could only proceed from the counsel and dominion of an intelligent and powerful being. Newton says, this being governs all things not as a soul of the world, but as Lord over all. And on account of his dominion, he is to be called God, the universal ruler. Now, let us look at the ground reality. These are the most beautiful women in the world. There are some people who are born and they become most beautiful people in the world. And look at this reality, ugliest woman in the world. This lady was born ugly, and she has got a title saying ugliest woman in the world. And world's most handsome men in the year 2021. Ugliest man in the world. These are all ground realities. Some people are stinking rich, and some people are poverty stricken. Some people, they are born intelligent and they become doctors, engineers, and take up the top roles in the society. And some people, they remain as coolies or laborers throughout their life. Some people are born with silver spoon, and some people are born with no food for that particular day. The question is, who decides all these things? Friends, let us discuss and explore who decides these things and why some people are born rich, some people are born poor, some people are stinking rich, some people are throughout their life they work as coolies, some people are born beautiful, some people are born as ugliest. So why all these things? Who decides and what happens and what are our choices in life? All these things we will discuss in the next session. Thank you very much.